Governance of principles and all that?
Well, you know, the thing is that in Buddhism, for example, in Theravada Buddhism, I mean, there is a story that the Buddha, I mean, did not accept nuns as a part of the community immediately. I mean, there is a story, you know, that he says that after a few attempts, I mean, there were some disciples who tried to convince him that there should be nuns also. So finally he accepted, but this was not something which is automatic, so to say. While in Jainism, I mean, we don't see anything like that. I mean, we see that the nuns were the part of the Sangha, I mean, right away. I mean, there was no discussion about whether to include them or not, you know. So this is one thing. And then in today's communities, I mean, for example, in Theravada countries, there are some ladies who can be called nuns, but they are not at all on the same level as monks. For example, in Thailand, there are some ladies who are white clad and they are called maichis. So they are supposed to be like nuns, but they are not at all like the bhikkhus. They are more or less kind of a servant in the temples, and they have a very, very subordinate role. So that is quite different. Because, of course, in Jainism, I mean, the nuns have to follow more rules than the monks. Their life is more strictly framed, so to say, than the life of monks. But at the same time, you don't have the impression, and the system is not that they should.